Two young scholars got to US for their master's degree program. There, they met a mentor, Professor John Paul Ledwack.
I will always, at the slightest opportunity, give kudos and pay tribute to the two African scholars who founded ONEP, Dr. Sam Doe and Honorable Emmanuel Bombande. Their vision is what has kept ONEP today. And everything we do is on the basis of their idea, belief, and conviction that Africans can run an institution and run it very well.
It's amazing how time flies. It's already 20 years. And I look back and say, we've come a long way. I remember meeting the former executive director, or I'll say immediate past, Emmanuel Bombande, in South Africa. He was the main facilitator in a youth training that I was attending. That was in 1998. So when he saw me and knew I'm from Ghana, he asked whether I was interested in joining them since they were setting up a peace building organization in Ghana.
18 years ago, when I joined ECOWAS, under a project supported by USAID, West African Office, the Catholic Relief Services was given a project to establish the early warning system at the ECOWAS Commission. And ONEP overwhelmingly came first.
J'ai commencé ma mission le 2 juin 2003.
Et je me rappelle l'activité phare que nous avions organisée, c'est les conducteurs de taxi moto que nous avons pris, nous avons mis ensemble et nous leur avons enseigné les notions de non-violence et de démocratie. Donc ça a été vraiment une activité qui nous a donné du top dans la société togolaise. Donc un coup de pouce, disons, on a avancé et c'est à partir de là que le travail de ONEP a commencé à être reconnu. Donc nous avons travaillé avec les jeunes des partis politiques, nous avons travaillé avec les responsables des partis politiques eux-mêmes, les femmes, les enseignants, les élèves, même dans les marchés, les femmes revendeuses. Donc on a initié de petites actions qui aujourd'hui portent des fruits dans la célébration de ces 20 ans de ONEP. Nous ne pouvons que nous réjouir du petit apport que nous avons eu et qui nous a donné du succès au niveau de ONEP Togo.
ONEP is a family for me. It's a workplace, but it's a family. I still have friends, colleagues over there. We still discuss how we can let work better to promote peace in the region.
Ma rencontre avec ONEP s'est faite en 2011 et c'est depuis donc 2011 que j'ai commencé à collaborer avec le ONEP. À chaque élection, le ONEP fait partie d'un consortium qui appelle à l'apaisement, qui appelle à aller à des élections paisibles afin que nous ne tombions pas dans les conflits post-électoraux.
In the last 15 years, my organization Center for 21st Century joined just as a member. We were trained on peace building.
ONEP, c'est un réseau d'ONG ici au Bénin. J'ai connu ONEP depuis 2000 et je connais l'apport de ONEP. Et nous, en tant que ONG qui travaillons pour le développement communautaire dans les communautés, nous avons eu besoin d'être membres de ce grand réseau qui nous soutient dans la résolution des conflits avec, par exemple, nos coopératives de femmes, les animateurs que nous avons sur le terrain et qui renforcent justement ces animateurs-là.
20 years of an institution like ONEP is something that is worth celebrating.
Quand le programme ONEP est arrivé à Palémé, où là j'étais instructeur, nous avons vu ce que ONEP a fait. ONEP a commencé par les tout petits, parce que l'éducation change le monde. L'éducation change la mentalité.
I actually got into knowing ONEP a lot more when I joined the center in 2010.
From this humble beginning, then success.
ONEP has been able to cover the whole West Africa in terms of establishing a viable civil society network that works for conflict prevention. So we have ONEP Senegal, ONEP Guinea, ONEP Mali, ONEP Burkina Faso, and so on and so forth. across the 15 countries of the sub-region, ECOWAS. And so, of course, the regional office is located in Accra, Ghana, where we operate from, but we also have a national secretariat for Ghana, which is situated in the northern part of the country.
ONEP is known worldwide for its peace-building activities. We've worked very closely with them, and actually ONEP established a liaison office at the early warning directorate where I was at the time.
And ONEP programs are anchored on peace building, as our name reflects. ONEP is one of the pioneer peace building organizations in West Africa, in fact in Africa. And through our programs, the field of peace building has been greatly influenced, building on ONEP's examples and experiences from the field. In fact, now at the level of the United Nations, most of the concepts around peace building and how peace building is seen at that level is informed a lot by what ONEP does. Our peace building programs are looking at things from a preventive perspective. So we have programs like peace education, early warning, women in peace building and security. We also have programs on human security and human rights, as well as violent extremism.
ONEP, as we know, started from an humble beginning, and it has grown so widely with great impact in our country, Nigeria. ONEP is in all geopolitical zones in Nigeria, having different zonal coordinators, and each one have different projects. We in Lagos State, we have been so much enriched with capacity building from ONEP in respect to conflict prevention.
Their early warning and responses network has helped nip conflicts in the bud.
Also, one of the great targets in Lagos is the issue of early warning and early response system, which we call NEWS. And this is one of the remarkable achievements of ONEP in the past 20 years, because this has fed into the national early warning and response system.
One of the reasons why early warning became an integral program and also a life wire of ONEP since its inception is as a result of the lessons learned from the conflicts that bedeviled the West African region. Particularly of note is the conflict, the violent conflicts and the civil strife that happened in the Mano River region of West Africa, specifically Sierra Leone and Liberia, and then to some extent also Côte d'Ivoire.
Il y a de cela 4 ans, j'ai eu à travailler avec ONEP. Je travaille toujours avec ONEP d'ailleurs, dans le cadre de leur programme WIPNET, Women in Peace Building Network. Et donc j'ai été identifiée comme une femme leader pour participer à un atelier qu'ils ont organisé en 2014, où nous avons été formés sur les questions de la résolution de la paix, de la citoyenneté, des conflits et du rôle de la femme dans la consolidation de la paix au Togo.
20 years is not an easy, an easy time. They have accumulated a lot of experience in conflict prevention.
So far, ONEP has become a household name in international and global peace, as well as the continental arena.
In a context where many organizations, due to funding gaps and the competitiveness of the field, are not able to survive this long, I think it's a testament to ONEP's meaningful contribution to peace and security that the organization has not only just survived but thrived and grown and become very established.
ONEP, c'est une organisation avec laquelle nous avons beaucoup travaillé. Et depuis 2009 jusqu'en 2018. De 2009 à 2011, ils ont élaboré un document qu'ils ont expérimenté dans 53 jardins d'enfants de la région de Plateau-Ouest, précisément Palimé. Et puis, suite à cette expérimentation, nous avons senti avec la nécessité d'introduire les notions et les préoccupations qui étaient dans ce qui est l'éducation à la paix dans les programmes de l'éducation préscolaire, puisqu'ils étaient le même dans les jardins d'enfants. Et donc, ensemble, on s'est mis. On a d'abord validé le guide qu'ils ont élaboré et puis nous leur avons dit bon, nous ne pouvons pas avoir un huitième programme pour le préscolaire, il y en avait 7. Il nous faut juste intégrer les valeurs de paix et de non-violence dans les curricula déjà élaborés pour le préscolaire.
WANEP has been a shining example of how civil society can make an effective contribution towards development in our sub-region.
WANEP has been an organization over the years that it's a very strong and remarkable organization on the continent, I mean more particularly within West Africa. WANEP's efforts at actually contributing to conflict prevention but also peace and security on the continent is a very important role that they are playing, especially from the civil society perspective.
Imbued with a dynamic built-in model, WANEP works successfully with both governments and other regional organizations, providing collaborative platforms to ensure peaceful transitions and stop election violence across the West African region.
I am reflecting now in terms of our partnership with the African Union, with the United Nations, ECOWAS, with all the regional economic communities, including now our relationship with ICAS. For a civil society organization to have gotten a memorandum of understanding with African Union and with ECOWAS and with the Kofi Annan International Peace Training Center and with the Nigerian Defense Academy and several national institutions is not in any way regarded as a mean feat.
And this signing of MOU with AU is one of the biggest achievements also that we're able to achieve. It gives us opportunity to show how civil society work can easily work with the regional intergovernmental organization, and also show how we cover our most of the territory or areas at the local level.
Started contact with WANEP for Central Africa sometimes around, I should say 15 years ago or something. I was working on DRC conflict and I heard about the work that was being done here in West Africa by WANEP. I was invited by WANEP and I went with the team of WANEP in Tamale, in the villages there where there was an ethnic conflict that created insecurity up in the north and where WANEP was intervening.
For UN Women, we have worked with WANEP to promote women's participation in peace and security processes in the Sahel, and more specifically, more recently also in Nigeria. And I must say that the nature of our collaboration has been positive. WANEP's contribution has always been professional, and they really have served us and continue to serve as a standard setter in terms of collaboration between the United Nations and civil society partners.
They started working with the African Union, and the work they're providing is not an easy thing. They are really contributing to the entire continent in its early warning and conflict prevention task.
Donc WANEP ne m'est pas inconnu comme organisation de la société civile, et c'est avec beaucoup de plaisir que j'ai retrouvé WANEP Bénin sur mon chemin à l'occasion des élections. Je voudrais ici encore une fois saluer leur action à l'occasion des prises. Je pense que sans cette plateforme, nous n'aurions pas pu obtenir les résultats optimums que nous avons eus. Ils ont été à nos côtés. Depuis le début, ils ont servi de salle d'alerte. À chaque instant où il y avait un quelconque problème à un quelconque endroit du territoire du Bénin, on était informé et dans la mesure du possible, on essayait de régler le problème.
Ils nous ont produit un rapport et ce rapport-là contient tout ce qui a été observé comme faiblesse, comme force. Mais nous avons eu surtout l'occasion d'apprécier les observations concernant les faiblesses parce que c'est elles qui vont nous permettre de nous améliorer. Par conséquent, notre collaboration avec WANEP a été une coopération très fructueuse et nous souhaitons, sinon même que nous voulons la maintenir au cours des prochaines élections que nous aurons à partir de 2019.
One of the critical area in which we have worked with ONEP is on the issue of food security. And when we are talking about food security and peace, it is very, very important. It is the very basis of the society, because if there is no food, there will not be peace. So we've been working with ONEP on this issue. And we also know that climate change is impacting on our ability to produce more food for our people.
ONEP's engagement with KAIPT has been in existence before that, but I think that it also got solidified within the context of having a memorandum of understanding with the KAIPTC to engage in different collaborative activities in order to actually contribute to conflict prevention and also contribute to peace and security on the continent.
Il a collaboré avec le ONEP sur plusieurs plans. Il me plaît ici d'aborder notamment la collaboration que nous avons eue dans le cadre du plaidoyer pour la mise en place d'une loi sur le droit d'accès du public à l'information. Nous avons été sollicités pour accompagner le ONEP, ce qui un peu partout dans cette campagne de sensibilisation, un peu partout sur le territoire national. Nous sommes allés à Bomekalabi, nous sommes allés à Cotonou, on apporte nos voix à Parakou, pour à la rencontre de la société civile pour pouvoir expliquer la nécessité de passer à une loi d'accès à l'information. Et ce qui est plus important, c'est de préciser que le ONEP a initié pour la première fois dans notre pays ce que nous pouvons appeler le présimètre. Le présimètre, c'est cet outil qui permet de suivre les promesses du candidat qui est devenu président de la République. J'ai été notamment sollicité pour évaluer les promesses du candidat dans le domaine, pas le ONEP, dans le domaine des médias. Cela permet d'apprécier un peu ce que le candidat a promis, devenu président de la République. Est-ce que les promesses électorales se tiennent? Je crois que c'est une expérience originale que le ONEP est en train de mener dans notre pays.
But it's not always easy. Sometimes conflicts break out and threaten to consume an entire country or even the sub-region.
I think that this 20 years experience has given us an idea of the possibilities that exist in Africa.
With a highly professional board.
It's almost like an association of various civil society organizations working towards one purpose. And the international board is made up of people with varied experiences across West Africa. You'll find people from various backgrounds here. So the main business of the board is to offer guidance and advice based on members' own experiences, their backgrounds, to enable the ONEP head office, which is based in Accra, to function effectively. In other words, we are more like policy direction and supervision, and making sure that ONEP International or West African ONEP lives up to its own goals and expectations.
Having been at the head of WACSOF, there was a lot of fighting on prerogatives, what you know the board should be doing. Everybody was involved in programs, and I find it really very good, you know, the relationship that, you know, the board is on policy. They don't care about, you know, getting involved in programs. And I think this is really what I see. And it is added value to the way, you know, ONEP is functioning.
The ONEP Regional Board and the management of ONEP has brought to play as we move forward. It's about honoring those people who have worked hard in the establishment of ONEP, those people who have been part of ONEP, those people who are professionals in the area of peace building and water building. There are some people who have been part of ONEP and are going, and we thought that it would be very, very important to give them a role to play.
An able, dedicated staff.
Here that we are today, courtesy of the support of our partners. I think that taking this forward, we now begin to reflect on where we are taking OneUp to in the nearest future. If you look at other civil society organizations, they may engage in issues of criticisms and agitations, as well as human rights activities. But we have chosen a trajectory that we want to continually work on, which is the fact that it is possible to engage with the government without compromising your independence and also maintaining your autonomy.
This organization is poised for a greater future, and the world will be a better place for it.